after what I emailed you, I had contacted many therapist's offices and was told to check myself into a mental hospital, go to seek help in an asylum. My issue was beyond their help. Been idyllic since I got married 2 years ago to Rob. It really has. We got married in Hawaii, and it was just the best wedding ever. We had the best memories from that day, and since then it's just been, I think we've had one fight. So my relationship with my husband is very, very loving. So I want to start by saying that, and that, you know, this makes it all the more difficult to carry this with me every day, this truth that no one else can see, because my life is so loving and I am so connected with my husband. So, a year ago, we found out that I was pregnant, and I was so happy. Oh my goodness. Fell into place, and this sounds like such a stereotype, or what am I trying to say, a trope, but I really felt like there was something empty inside me that was filled the moment I found out that I was having a baby, and that's always been our goal, is to have children. So I was just very happy. I was one of those pregnant moms that was just glowing 24/7. I was just like, I always had this, like Rob said, I had this like shine to my face, like a halo on my face all the time, because I was so happy. Yeah, we had a baby shower, all these little cute outfits. Of course, we had to find out the sex, and we found out that it was a girl and decided to name her Charlotte. So, yes, the anticipation was there. And then finally, one evening, so we went to the hospital, and I went into labor. It was an excruciating labor for me. It was like, I think, 8 hours. I know more women go through a lot longer, a lot more excruciating labors. But it, for me, it was the biggest pain I've ever been through in my life. But it was so worth it, or I thought at the time, because finally, you know, the nurses had faith in me and they kept encouraging me, push, 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 and I was strong enough and I did it. And I felt Charlotte leaving my body and I was just like, oh my gosh, this is what life is. Like I felt so human in that moment, just so connected to like my purpose to reproduce, and all the hormones came, let's just say that. And so they took Charlotte away to clean her up, and I was just so anxious to see her. And the nurses came toward me with a blanket, and I was like, that looks like a tiny blanket, you know, okay. And they handed me my baby, and my first thought was, this, she's so light, you know, for that big labor I just went through. I was expecting Charlotte to be a lot heavier. I was like, oh my gosh, I feel like I'm holding nothing, and that just warmed my heart, because babies are so small and perfect, you know? literally an apple, a dark red apple, like that you buy from the grocery store. I mean, it was large. She's like this big, but it's an apple. And my first thought was, oh, the nurses are playing a prank on me. And I laughed, but in the back of my mind, I thought, this is just so unprofessional. Well, where's my baby? So I, you know, I was polite and laughed for a bit, and I said, where's my baby? And the look that they gave me, I'll never forget. It was like one of concern, and they said, this is Charlotte, this is your baby, congratulations, mom. And I looked down again, and it's an apple. Went to the other side of the room. I heard them talking about, oh, you know, the post-birth craziness that some women have. I was like, what crazy? I'm holding an apple in my arms. And my husband came in. And I thought, oh, thank God. Thank God Rob's here. Because he can agree with me. And so I showed him this apple. He started crying, he started like, he touched her, saying he was playing with her little nose. And I was like, what nose? This is an apple. This is a freaking apple that I have in my arms. And he lifted up this apple, just like this, and kissed it, and hugged it. And I thought, this is a joke, right? And so I asked Rob, I said, this is an apple. Where's my baby? Where's Charlotte? Where's Charlotte? And he just looked at me like I was crazy, and he started to get very concerned. He said, this is our baby, this is Charlotte. She's your dark hair and all that. And I just became very still then. Became very still because I know that he did not just go through 9 months of pregnancy and countless hospital and doctor bills and Lamaze class to give birth to an apple from the grocery store. I was just filled with rage, but I decided, okay. And it felt really like I was in, it felt surreal, like I was in some television show. Because everyone around me, the doctor was like, oh, I was baby Charlotte holding up the apple. I didn't want to hold it. I just said, oh, you know, you can check on her. Like, Rob, I think you should spend some time with her. I don't want to hold the freaking apple. I didn't want to sit there and play along, you know? But I realized, like, how, in what a precarious position I was in. Because women aren't respected when it comes to mental health, especially pregnant women. There's that whole stereotype that pregnant women are crazy and blah blah blah. And so I just knew that it wasn't safe for me to keep calling her an apple. So I was still for about 3 hours, and I guess call it survival instinct, but I started to play along. And so they brought home this apple. And you know, my breasts were full of milk. And Rob said, are you gonna feed the baby? And I'm looking at this apple like, okay. So I just took my breasts and I squeezed the nipple. And some milk came out and it just spilled all over the apple. It just dripped down the apple. Charlotte, oh, you know, yeah, she's getting so much bigger. And we take pictures with Charlotte, you know, me holding this apple. And Rob hangs them up on the wall. He frames these pictures. He posts them on Facebook of me and an apple. And an apple. I don't know what's wrong. Like, we bought this stroller, right? And so I go out on walks and I just put the apple in the stroller like a crazy person. And I'm just, you know, down the street. People stop and compliment me on how beautiful my baby is. It's an apple. I could eat it. I've thought about that too. In fact, I love apples. Not really the red ones, the green ones, but I feel very uncomfortable buying them now. I don't buy apples anymore. Because it's just very creepy to me. Because the more that I start to, you know, dress this apple, put this apple in baby clothes, even though it doesn't fit. This apple is just swimming. I see an apple now. I'm like, is that a baby? Or is that an apple? And I'm deathly afraid to have sex again or give birth to a baby because what if it's another apple? Is there something wrong with me? Is it a me problem? Or is it a Rob problem? That's why I'm coming to you. Because I think it might be a me problem. This baby as an apple, because it is an apple. Can I show you some pictures? Sorry. Okay. Here. Okay. Right. Now it's like she was never there, and I have this inanimate object that I have to walk around the house, pretend like I'm feeding, pretend like I'm playing with it, pretend like I'm changing its diaper. It's just, it's madness. It's madness. So I'm not quite sure what to do. That's where we're at, and we're trying to hire a nanny soon. I think that's the best. I really want to go back to work, because this is really, really, like, messing with me. I don't want to pretend like this apple is a baby anymore. So there's that. So there's the grief that I'm going through. Just, you know, me at birth. You know, what is it like, Sleeping Beauty? Wasn't there something like that? Or Snow White or something. But my baby's an apple, you know, and I'm the only one that sees it as an apple. I've had a lot of gin and tonics since I'm still breastfeeding, but I don't give a crap. And I'm not, as an apple, what was an apple make it sick? Right, so I've just been drinking a lot of gin and tonics and putting them in water bottles and all like Polar Pop, like cups, and telling Rob that it's Sprite because I'm just like, I can't live in this reality anymore. I cannot live in this reality. What happens when we have to register for school? Like preschool. And like stab it, or like I said, eat it. But I'm like, why should I have to raise it? Why should I have to? Do I teach it how to read? Do I teach an apple how to read? Like, I'm an intelligent person. I work for a marketing company. I did not take all this time off of work to like raise an apple. So when Rob's gone, I will just like set the apple in the crib. And I'll just, you know, do my work for 8 hours. I won't even like check on it because it's an apple and it's fine. I come back, there's just an apple sitting there, you know. Yeah. And then Rob will come home and I'll be like, oh, Charlotte's crying. Did you? Why don't you? She's crying. You don't hear her crying. I'm like, no. He hasn't told me, like I'll feed it in front of him, but I stopped feeding it during the day, and it's fine. Rob's like, oh, you know, she's growing healthy and strong and everything. It's just like, every once in a while, he will wake me up and say that the baby's crying, and so I'm like, okay, just play along. I'm laughing now. I mean, it's a mess, really, so I'm not quite sure what to do. Next week and give you more updates.